Andrew McGarr, IFL TV, in association with MTK Global. I'm here at the Newcastle Eagles Arena for the MTK Newcastle show. With me, I've got Gary Forrest. Nice seeing you again, Gary.
Andrew,
mate.
Left
hand handshake there. What a night, what an atmosphere. You must be pleased.
I told you in the last interview what would happen if we got a good show and a good venue. The people of Newcastle and the North East will come out, support the fighters. You've seen what's happened tonight from the first fight through to the last fight. Atmosphere's been brilliant. You know, when Joe Laws has come out, the whole place has erupted.
You've seen
the effect of the lad there with the crowd. Brilliant night, absolutely fantastic. The arena is absolutely tailor-made for boxing shows of this sort of size, you know, and absolutely brilliant and over the moon with it. Everything we wanted worked out well.
When you look at the card up and down, you've got some quality young fighters from the North East there. Who stands out for you then?
There was a lot. Virtually every one of them has stood out tonight. There's been some lads have stepped up to another level tonight. I thought Chad Edless went and fought really, really well. Six rounds, didn't put a foot wrong for six rounds. Troy's gone and stopped his opponent. But hey, I think the performance of the night, and nobody can deny this, is Simon Villaley's knockout.
Simon
Villaley. Did you not?
No, I was too busy. I was doing interviews backstage. Yeah. I came through, and he was already walking out the ring.
Yeah.
So
well, I think that was the performance of the night, because TK came genuinely thinking he was going to win the fight. Mm-hmm. Genuinely thinking he was going to win the fight. He thought he had a great chance, and Simon's produced a fantastic performance.
Well, I spoke to Simon. He says that he's probably more suited up at heavyweight in terms of he doesn't have to make weight and stuff like that. He says the last fight, the weight killed him. Do you echo that? Do you feel like this is the heavyweight division's made for Simon Villaley?
To a degree. I mean, we've got to remember Simon walks around about 16 stone, and some of these heavyweights, but some of these lads are walking around 18 stone, 18 and a half stone. So there are a lot of good quality heavyweight fights out there for Simon to take part in. I think that's what we've got to look at. Be careful about who we put him in with, but you know, there's opportunities, genuine opportunities. And all I asked of Simon tonight was two things. One was to put on a good performance in the ring, mm-hmm. and demonstrate and show everybody that he had that fire left in his belly again. You can't ask any more than that. And then you then had that followed on by Joe Laws. He's just the way
some
he fights.
It's
the way he fights. He gets the whole crowd there because he's in the face constantly. It's brilliant. It's brilliant to watch. And you know, so there's been some really good performances. And then Troy's getting a stoppage there as well. Mm-hmm. And I think there's an opportunity. We've got to, you know, somehow or other, we've got to try and get what would be great for the next one. Would be to Troy to be fighting for a title. Joe Laws. Mm-hmm. Fighting again, and maybe is that Northern Area title fight.
Sorry to cut you off, Gary, but here's the question I've got for you. These guys are relatively short in the pro game. They're 4-5-0, 6-0, 7-0, and whatnot. The guys here down the line, they are going to be fighting for titles. Is this arena big enough?
Possibly not. We'll see. I mean, I think if we opened all things, we'd get 3,000 people in here. Whether it could hold a world title fight is a different argument. We've seen what happens when Lewis Ritson is fighting for a European title. So I think we might, you know, it's the perfect arena for where these lads are now, for the British title fights, for the European title fights, maybe. And then if one of them makes it through to the next level, then we probably have to move it and start going down the arena.
Metro Radio, St. James's Park?
Probably possible. St. James's Park would be fantastic, but we've got to get somebody to that level first. I think what we've seen tonight, we've seen virtually every one of the lads has won the fights. There's been terrific performances. The crowd have been fantastic. The streaker really made the night.
The streaker, I've not mentioned that to any of my IFL viewers, but maybe you can just explain what happened.
Well, immediately.
Wasn't a male streaker?
Female streaker. As soon as Joe's fight would finish, she decided to strip off and do a lap of honour for everybody, which is fair play. And I think it just rounded the night off, really.
Then I was quite surprised because she pulled her dress down, but she never got her dress from under her feet, so she was waddling. And I was like, oh,
the funny thing was watching the security chasing after her. They couldn't catch her, and she was.
Well, that might have been that's what's been my night. I think the female streak in that morning.
There's been some great fights. Yeah. There's been a magnificent atmosphere. I think a lot of people have turned up tonight to this arena for the very first time and not knowing what to expect. Mm. And I think what will have happened after tonight, a lot of people are going, wow, what an arena, some great boxing, what an atmosphere. You've got to come.
Yeah.
They'll be telling their friends, you've got to come to the next show. And that's, I think, next time around, even if we put the same lads on, we would get another 50% people in, you know. So you know, delighted with the night, and hopefully it's the start of a few.
Definitely. One more thing. You said in my last interview with you in your office, you said that the North East is a sleeping giant. Do you think that's the North East is waking up now?
Starting to wake up.
Yep.
We've got to keep building on it. We can't be complacent, but it is absolutely a sleeping giant. We just haven't had somewhere to develop an arena in which to develop the shows. And I think, you know, this could be that arena.
Good stuff. I won't keep you much longer. It's getting late. Yeah. You're probably going to go out in the town and paint the town red.
No, bed. Nice and early night.
Same here. I've got another 2-hour drive up the road, but that's neither here nor there. Again, Gary, thanks for your time. Thanks for everything you've done for me this, the last time I was down in tonight. You've been an absolute joy. Thanks very much, Gary.
No problem.
I'll speak to you soon. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.